Look at him. He's floating in the air like some kind of oh.
So yes, welcome Saga, RedMcNed. You to the. I think that's all the words. Yeah. So this is what we did last time. Put a little farm, moved it more like, and there's a little river there. And there's still kind of, it's obviously incomplete. Let's get down. I probably didn't have to remove the sugarcane here, so I think I'll be putting it back. But something more important to talk about here is that I want to put something on this hill. I feel like almost every place that's ever built usually needs some sort of big thing to be like its center or its like its main thing. Like, I don't know, in fantasy and stuff, whenever there's like an important town or important city or important area, there's always like a landmark or something that defines that place. And for this place, I would like it to have a clock tower. So this is sort of derived from a comment from one of my other videos saying that I should try to make the clock tower from Majora's Mask. And at first I thought that it would be kind of redundant because I'd seen a lot of pictures of people already doing it. But there aren't that many tutorials on how you could build it. And I think that I might be able to actually make it automated. Make it actually a working type tower. And I think it would look really good right here, to be honest. So this will probably be the most ambitious thing I try to do on here so far. But I want it to be right here. I want it to be overlooking the land. And I want it to be seen by all. So, in order for me to do that, though, I need to get some more resources. Especially if I'm going to be using redstone. And I'm going to be building with a lot of cobble. Or I'm going to need a lot of cobble to build this. It's a pretty big structure. I found out. And if I'm putting it on a hill, it's just going to be that much bigger. Especially if I want to do, like, supports or anything. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a lot of caving, or a lot of, not necessarily caving, but branch mining, and I'll probably put some footage of that toward the end of the video, montage style, and I'm going to make it so that if you like it, you can watch it. If you don't want it, we should skip right into building this thing, like, now. Alright, so I did some mining, and did some bookshelf things for enchanting. And I got some pretty darn good equipment, and I have some pretty darn good minerals, and some pretty darn good cobblestone, and those are pretty awesome too. So I think that we're ready for the big deal, the big project of this episode. So, you guessed it, phoning a friend. Hi there, I'm looking for a design for a tower clock thing, video game maybe inspired and such. I'm gonna get you. Whoops, I'm showing everything. Well, yes, I'm glad you called. It turns out that I just so happen to have been working on a clock tower design, so da-da-da. I'll give you a little bit of a view of this beauty. There's a couple ways you can do this. You can either do it this way, and I'll show you how to build this. I'm not just going to show you this and be like, okay, later, ha-ha-ha. No, I'm going to show you how to make this stuff. This is one version of it, where it's got the clock face. There's some pretty cool designs of this out there, but this is kind of my attempt at it. And I'll do a nice circular view to show the structure is all kind of there. And the stuff over there that I'm showing, that you can see, is something a little extra I want to try to do. I used the technology from a video. Let me check my sources really fast. Okay, I got it. So a guy goes by a YouTuber by the name AKA Germinator had a oh there it goes had a really interesting design for a working clock, and he basically made this device here, this contraption that's sort of like a TV screen that as it as the mechanism inside goes, we'll see if it goes. Yeah, there it goes. The whole thing shifts, so it's like a moving thing. And he even has this nifty little device where the cart gets slowed down by the spider webs, and I think he had two for his version, but I have one just to speed things up a little bit. But it triggers this, goes hits this, this goes up there, there's a torch under there, and does the whole thing. And whoa. Ooh, got a little lightheaded there, flung around. So I decided to make a version of that with the clock that is a little bit, I would say it was ambitious to go for it, but now that I'm kind of happy that I made it work. This is definitely the first redstone thing I've made, and I'm setting the bar pretty high, I think, with this. But basically, how this works is I took the time, I didn't put the timing mechanism in the middle, but there's, well, I guess I did. Okay, never mind. Don't listen to me. So I have two TV screen looking things, but the thing is, when they go, well, when they get triggered, and I'll push this to demonstrate, they both go opposite directions. So if I was to, here, I have this loop over here, keep pushing it at intervals. Basically, it would do something like this. So it's the closest I can get to a working clock tower from Majora's Mask, because the face of the tower moves, and it isn't like minute hands, so I'm basically filling up space right now to just be able to watch this work. But I think it's as close as I can get to make it seem like it's spinning, because right now it's upside down from the design over there. It's roughly the design of the other one, and I think that we can fit this onto there inside of it somehow. Here's the thing at work. The signal goes up this. What? It goes, whoa, it goes into the sky. So what I'm gonna do for you is, and by you, I'm talking about myself in the game. Oh, look at that timing, that perfect timing. What I'm gonna do for myself in the game is I'm going to give you, and by you I mean me, the knowledge to build this. So have at it. Oh hey, I'm suddenly filled with the knowledge to be able to do this. I wish everything worked that way. You know what? I'll bring the ladder too, because that might make things easier. I want to put that thing on top of this. I want to be able to see it from everywhere in the village, and I want it to see the village from here. So I'm gonna kind of prepare this top for it. Oh man, this shovel. Oh, it's amazing. I'm not gonna bring this entirely down, but I do want it to look like it's supported by it a little bit. And the thing is actually pretty tall, so I'm not really too worried about it not being able to be seen. I think I might just go down to maybe this level. So what I'll do is mark the corners with this. So, Oh, I guess another interesting thing is how do I want it centered? on this mountain. So I'm gonna take another look. Kind of there-ish, I suppose. So where that torch is, that's where the center will be. So if this is the middle, maybe I will go down one more. It's okay if some of it hangs over the edge. That just means it'll have character. That's what having character is hanging over the edge. So this is an 11 by 11 square. It's not going to be filled in, and the corners are going to have stone brick. So if this is the middle, it's a 1, 2, 3. And on the fifth one, stone brick. So do that to make it a square. These torches cannot hang around long, so I'm going to put them on the outside. Maybe on the inside too. Next, I'll take this design and make it 5 tall. So counting the bottom one, there's going to be one here and then 2, 3, 4, 5. All right, so now this is 5 total, and this is why I brought the crafting tables. We need to make some stairs. So for this part, it's just gonna make a row of stairs with brick on the outside. Or on the outsides, I should say. And that way it'll turn and make a nice corner piece. So the corners will be the stairs facing out, and the sides will be stairs also. And now that this has happened, the corner will be a up one, and will be a stone brick, and the insides will be cobble. Once this is all around, like so, this whole section will go up 11 blocks total, so 10 of them on top of the ones that are already here. And whatever blocks on the bottom, that's what's going up. And nighttime means sleep time and ladder time. All right, now it's the exact same stair thing again, where it's each corner has stone brick stairs, and every side is cobble. The pattern's just going to keep continuing for a little bit, so this will be 3 tall, though, and all the way around. And up here, we'll do the corners same. Corners same, inside same. And yet again, we're continuing the pattern. And this will go up three. Didn't quite plan that out. All right, so at this point, it should look like a 5x5 sort of square with cobble in the middle of each sides. I'm gonna make some half slabs of bricks and put them on the corners. That will happen like so. And just so I don't fall into a horrible death, I'll just kind of help this out with half slabs. We're gonna make some cobble walls right now. I see the night coming. Make like four. Click this four times. That should be enough. Put these back. I'm gonna figure out how to use this ladder to get up and down. So, if I just click shift, I hold in place, and I can build a ladder as I'm going down. This is kind of hilarious, actually. What the hell? All right, so there's going to be a square around this. Whoops, not there. And this will be sort of a way up. I'm gonna keep this part open so we can get inside. This will be too tall. Too tall. And now we're gonna start with the big bulbous top thing. So I'm gonna jump on top of this and work from the bottom up. The first part is just putting down a ring. Actually, I could just probably show it easier than say it. This is all going to be cobble. So, upside down stairs on each of these. And there's going to be the next level up. Each side's going to have three of those on it. Then each of these is going to be bordered with a half slab on the top. Next, each of those is going to have cobble on top of it. And each of these corners will be turned into a complete square. And these middle three will have cobble on each side of them. Or sticking out, I should say. Right, the everything on the outside is going to go up one. So getting out the stairs, each side is going to have a step and sort of a step pattern like that. And everything else is going to be a half slab on that level. I think we can, yeah, we can light this up just a little bit. We're high enough up that I don't think anything's gonna come after us, which is nice. So we're gonna go ahead and fill in each of these rows of three here with cobble. Just going sideways from the stairs. And we're going to have a stair and two half slabs on each of those. And a half slab has to go in these corners, so I might just put one down, another one on top to make it even. And do the same thing on all the sides. Now we're going to be making a bit of a plus sign connecting all of the stairs in the middle. And on each side of these, there's going to be stairs. And the middle is going to be solid, so maybe that'll help. So I can do stairs like this. We can take away the one in the middle. And it's going to be half slabs all the way around this. And by that I mean this little ring here. And oh, I didn't do all of the stairs. There we go. I can throw a torch in there. All of this should be not spawnable blocks. Or they're close enough, or the blocks are close enough to the torch that it's too bright for them to spawn. So I'm gonna go down now. And then we can work on the outside. For the side wheels, we're gonna have to get all of our wood reserves going. Oh, good. And a nice pillar for dirt. So the part that comes out for the wheel isn't directly down, but or one down, but two down. So this is the part of the step, and then skip one, and that's where the center of the wheel is. And this gives you a nice visual cue of where on the structure we are. This wheel will be the same on both sides, and it starts with a log, so we might as well do that. I guess this one doesn't matter because we won't be able to see it, but that'll be the outside of the wheel. We have to make a nice, I guess, plus sign out of oak planks. And this one is going to go out two more. And the other side's going to go out two more as well. I can put in part of the log wheel section, so I can put that there. Wood's very directional how you place it, so I have to put those blocks there. Yeah, I think this will do. Jump down, hopefully I don't die. Good. So there are going to be two more, one there and one below that, but I can't really reach those yet. I can go around this really fast and join up the rest of this, maybe. And I built myself into a corner. The stairs gonna be tricky. I'm just gonna make a nice platform. I think that's gonna make whoa, that's gonna make this a little easier. All right, I've made a few steps, so if we put an upside down one there, right side up, upside down. Whoa, I put two simultaneously. It's kind of weird. Get a design that looks a little bit like that. Do the same thing on this side too. It kind of looks like a wheel. I'll do the bottom half. It's going to be a mirror image. As soon as I find a safe way down there. All right, that's safe enough. Gonna finish this. Might have to jump. Okay. Coming at it from behind with these. There we go. Oh yeah, I have to play these backwards. All right, there's the wheel minus the wool. And go ahead and put one exactly the same on the other side. All right, a bit more complicated than, creative mode, but I suppose that's how survival is. It's just survival. All right, I need to chop down more stuff. Ugh. We're gonna need some wool for this next thing. So what I'm going to do is, for now, I'm going to build the version that's not automated. So this is just what it looks like without any moving parts. Because I think on its own, it's a pretty cool build too. But this is sort of tucking in the wool. It's the cyan is toward the outsides, and the light blue is toward the inside. A pattern kind of like this. Oops. Well, I guess I'll be getting that. And just so there's no mobs that spawn here, I'm gonna throw a torch somewhere. Probably back behind it. Like that. I'm gonna do the other side now. Same stuff. Light on the inside, darker on the outside. Oh, I forgot that stair. Whoops. Little bit of stone, just a little bit. And okay, there's actual oak, so we're good. Now the center of the wheel should be, or the face should be the same height as the center of the sides. Which I forgot to put a connector right there. Whoops. Did I forget that with this side too? No, I remembered. Weird. So I'm going to use the wood for this. It's going to be at eye level. Find the middle. And boom! That's where it is. I believe the entire face of the clock will be constructed around this. So I'm going to put a plus sign in with these. Assuming I can actually do it. It's tricky. It's not always guaranteed. And I'm going to leave that there because I don't trust myself. So I'm going to start putting in the colors. I'm going to start right here. And I'm just going to be keep going up, kind of making sort of a scaffolding here. Scaffolding. That should help. The birch. I like the birch for this because it looks like the actual little tick marks on the clock. In case you were wondering, this is very heavily influenced by the clock in Majora's Mask. At Clock Town. So much so that it's basically what this is. So to keep stuff from spawning on this, I think I will throw some torches around. Alright, time to build down to get to the rest of this. I think I might go ahead and put a torch right there just to light up the clock face. All right, I think that just about does it. I'm going to clean this up and we can take a look at it. Now, before I show it, I want to stress the fact that I am going to eventually make this the automated version, but for the sake of time and just showing the non-automated version and how to build it, I've made it. So, there it is. And I have to say, I'm pretty freaking happy with that. I am really happy, actually. That looks really freaking awesome. I mean, freak! Freak! Yeah. I think I can see it from almost. Oh, I'm going back toward
Here we are.
base. I think I can see it from almost everywhere. Yeah, even the houses way over here. That is an awesome addition to this place. I think I'm finally too far away over here. Oh wow, so it shows up even here. And I can only guess how cool that would look if it was also moving. But even if not, that is really cool. You know what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna actually clean up the supports a little bit so it's not so blocky on the bottom. Looks like someone took a bite. Oh, okay, never mind. What I think I'm going to do for the supports is just take this design and bring it down until it hits something that makes sense. Like, that doesn't make sense. That makes sense. All right, there we go. It's oops. Looks like it sort of worked into the mountain in a way that makes sense. And this is just the back of it. Wow, that's all that actually turned out being a really nice spot for it. Man, it's almost like I'm taking this Minecraft thing seriously, giving it a big old thing like that. Like you thought this was your 5-year-old's, 2-year-old's video game playthrough. No, I want to make stuff like this. So now that that's done and made, I can go ahead and show a few of the other things that happened in this. So now we're in the bonus section of this video where I eat. So, standard things like gardening. Oh no! Oh no! All right, maybe I should do a spot for the sheep. All right, I'm going to make a temporary area for sheep. All right, before I do any sort of mining, I have to enchant stuff. I want to get some good enchants so I can go fast. I want to go fast. There's so many cows. Now I'm pretty sure I need 45 books to make 15 bookshelves. I have to go back into the mine now and get those diamonds from before. I guess I might as well just got them back in the day when I was already down here, but I didn't know. I'm gonna be trying to make a good shovel and a good pick. I have my lapis and I have all of these and I didn't just burn these all I could because of my strategy for enchanting. So this should be level 5. Okay. All right. So that's actually really promising. So I'll probably go ahead and get it. But if it said something I didn't like, then I could enchant one of these and it'll reset the table. Wowzy Bowsy Nowser. How? Okay, that's all right. That's my favorite pick in the whole game. Well, let's see what the shovel. Oh, I should have looked at this. All right, efficiency 4. That's pretty good. I think that you insta mine or insta dig gravel and sand at efficiency 3, but we'll see what 4 gets us. What will it do? Let's go for that. All right. I'm pretty darn happy with that. That shovel is pretty cool. I actually do like getting a silk touch on a shovel just because it doesn't immediately go into flint. But we don't have any flint right now, so this is good. So as you can see, you could actually go for quite a while without getting something specific in there that you might like. What I'm waiting for is either Silk Touch or Fortune 3. I'm pretty picky. See, there it is. Yeah! So, we don't need that just now, because, well, we don't need it just now. But that's a cool one to know it's there. It's not going to go away, even if we go away. So, I'm going to put this stuff into their spots. Let's try this one. Oh, that's a prettier sight. Much better. Well, I thought that might happen, but I was hoping it wouldn't. While I didn't want to go too much into detail about what the mining operation looks like down here, in between projects, if it's just branch mining, I do want to show if I make changes. And actually, I'm going to make a few right now. Just bringing this ladder down to a an easier to access level. Also, oh, it's. I think this might be the first rain on the server, or in this world. I guess that zombie doesn't see me. I don't think it's rained the whole time, so I'm gonna put these down. Ooh. Got spooked. I got spooked. Oh. Look what I found. Let's turn this off. Hello. Oh, I think I hear other things nearby. Oh, cool. So, I had a potato drop from a zombie not too long ago, and now I found some other very interesting things. Oh, okay. I thought I'd show you a little bit of this, but I'm finally lighting up the place with extreme prejudice against any sort of not light areas. Let's just say that. So sometimes the night's an easy time to do this. I think it's kind of a full moon, so it's not as many mobs are spawning. Maybe that's what's going on. If not, then I don't know what I'm talking about. But also the early evening is a good time to do this too. So then mob spawning isn't in full-blown booyah mode. So, but no one's really bugging me too much, and it's already almost morning. But yeah, I'm just like spamming torches. It doesn't matter where. I just don't want to have things spawning in here. It's as simple as that. So I've made this pen kind of almost exactly the way I did with the cows and bred up a bunch of sheep because we're gonna need some wool for this next thing. And I'm hoping that this is what we can use. I figure if we have the primary colors here, we can get secondary colors. Of course not. Why would this ever equal green? Because that equals purple. And that equals orange. Alright, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go on a little adventure. I'm going to make myself a compass so I can get back home. A lot of cobblestone, a lot of torches. This is just in case. Just in case I find a village. I might need to wall it off and light it up. Since this is on a hard difficulty mode. We have not found a village yet in this episode. I haven't, but especially we haven't. So I'm going to pick a direction and probably just walk. Oh, I forgot to bring my bed. So I think what I'm looking for is a desert. And I don't really know what it's going to take to get there. So I'm going to have boats with me just in case. This cactus might actually be the only way to get green in this game. Even though, just look at all the leaves. Oh, I never talked about this, but I enchanted the sword recently. That looks amazing. I feel like I'm officially going into the unknown, because those are the crazy mountains over there. But this is the crazy forest over here. Could be fraught with dangers and other whatnot. Wonder what other magical nonsense can be found here. Oh, wait! I'm going to find different types of flowers, aren't I? Yeah, I wonder if I should harvest some of these for their mushrooms. Oh, insta-mine. Oh, thank you. And there's the counterpart. So we'll have to get some of this, too. Oh! Ooh! Ooh! So that's... Orchids are probably one of my favorite flowers in this. So there's a swamp over here. That'll be good for possibly getting slimes. This is a very big ocean. I wish there was more that I could say about it. I did not know that there was a birch forest hills. These are freaking giant. Hey, what? What? I didn't crash into anything. What does that stop for? Oh, whoa! Mega Taiga. This is a new type of, well, it's not new, I guess, to the game. I forgot that this stuff existed. Podsoul. And then mossy stone. Cool. I have been traveling for so long. It's as if the background keeps repeating and repeating. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Oh! Oh! Ooh. Okay. That's quite the change of events. There's a mushroom island here. That is really good to know about. So spawn is that way. That's... Maybe I should write down the coordinates to that. Cold taiga. Close enough. Oh, something was gonna happen there. Must be lava right there. As I zigzag through the forest. Oh! Oh, I guess that creeper really did not care. Like, there's a severe amount of not caring. Oh, this looks nice. It's like a mesa. Savannah. A savannah. At least we're finding different biomes. Oh! What was that? There's like a mini desert thing. Oh. Okay. Oh, yeah. My eyes do not deceive me. It is, in fact, a desert. Oh, get over here. What do I... Nah, who needs that? Oh, wait. Yeah. Oh, yes. Good, 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 good. Homeward bound for the longest time. Well, look at all these wonderful, wonderful colors we have here. And if we combine these, yes, we get cayenne. So good. I think that we have almost all of the colors represented. This has been RedMcNed, and in the next episode, it's a very good chance that I'll be automating that. And we'll see what else happens. We'll see what else happens.